but it's not this active shoulder where I'm cranked forward. This is what's considered an active shoulder to a lot of people. A lot of people think that this is what they should be doing for an active shoulder. What they should be doing is taking that pinky and rotating it inward, right? Having that pinky rotate inward to give yourself tension in that scap area. So rotate inward, and what you have... rotate inward, and now you have that good kind of shoulder position, okay? Great, that exact same thing on the bar, what you'll see is someone go from this position, where their head is really close, to that shoulder being about a few inches away from their head, okay? So first you gotta find that active shoulder position. Now what we need to do is all the same squat mechanics apply, right? Butt back, making sure that what's maximally loaded is loaded first. So butt back, coming down into my squat. You might have to kick your feet out just a little bit. Going into that squat, keeping that chest up and choosing a fixed point to look at across the room, okay? Choose a fixed point to look at. So we're gonna grab our forward point. Yeah, and then find that middle ground. All right, guys. Let's try these over. Get down!
That's good. Good. So that's gonna be. I'm gonna watch him again.
That's fine. It's better to have that.
Oh, Ethan, look at that form.
That's so good, isn't it? So good. How could it be wrong when it feels so right?
Helps for frosting, but I kind of myself here. Is that
right? Yeah, so if you did not have any deviation of the bar, okay, if I did not say anything to you, if I said I have to come back to you, if you didn't have any deviation of the bar, you are good to go and start warming up your overhead squat. If you did have deviation of the bar, I'm going to choose specific things for you to work on. Jeremy,
could you drop that stopper, please?
Yeah, right? Yeah. Dude! You're like Rich Ronnie, he like does those thrusters.
Yeah.
He throws the last one up.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable. So I'll just put a little bit on it.
I would say, so it's right here.
You look so fantastic.
This chest.
Your dad is so tired. You're so good at this shit.
Okay. What I would do is, your dad would know exactly what to do. It's going to be just like one little drop song.
Yes.
I mean, how is it all?
Yes.
That's class.
Yeah, stop
Every beer, every fish and chips, I could smell during that workout. It was my favorite workout. What's that?
You put the pot on?
Yeah, but that dropped kind of. But that's
how I take off. I like the Golly Classic.
It's just. Sorry, man. Hopefully I won't drop it. You're more than one.
You good?
So essentially a snatch balance, but just, so not actually dropping. So coming into that clean, get in the front rack position, and then what you need to do is from here, you need to get in your back rack, okay? Doesn't have to be a full-on jerk, you don't have to be super proper and have a proper footwork. I just need that bar to come over and land on that back, okay? Now from here, we can kind of take a breather. We don't have to worry about the front rack position. I'm going to find my squat position, okay? Find my hands, and then into my overhead position, okay?
People work out some better mobility.
Yeah.
make sure that you find a good position. And the first few attempts, hand turns off, you're not really going to know your footing, but you'll find it pretty soon after. If you know your hand position, I take your hands, chalk them up real nice, grab the bar.